Many, if not most 3D printers have this issue, assuming you got rid of the wood grain pattern in the first place. I explain how I root caused and fixed this for my printers in my other video, which you can watch after this one. So once you're past the wood grain pattern and the problems caused by other axes, if you print this model, which I've linked in the description, you'll notice this little intertwined and very faint wave-like patterns. The vast majority of direct drive extruders have these, even if they're single gear, pretty much all of them. The only reason I see for the Bowden setups to get away from this is that the filament here acts a bit as a spring inside the tube and is able to smooth out the pattern to a large degree. This pattern is much smaller, so I need a model where the extrusion varies only a tiny, tiny little bit between the layers, reason why this model has the slope closer to the vertical, to elongate the pattern and make it easier to see. I'll skip the measuring process this time, you can see it in my other video, and I'll jump ahead to the conclusion. This distance takes as much filament as is in between two of these tiny little teeth. As they bite into the filament, one by one, they create one little faint wave. Now these teeth biting into the filament make some dents and displace the material like so. I don't know if it's the biting that moves the filament a bit up and down, or the displaced filament reaching the melting zone at an uneven volume, but it directly correlates with the uneven extrusion. So basically every extruder out there will show this pattern, except for Bowden setups which act a bit as a spring and smooth them out. Reason why a Prusa Mini gets smoother prints. Same for all Creality printers, except there they have other problems caused by the rollers, but that's another story. So that's where I believe this comes from. I guess one could try smoother teeth or some other approach. I haven't tried tempering with my gears, but I do have some clones lying around which I could maybe alter a bit. What would you say, should I try that at some point? As you can see, this is still an assumption and correlation does not mean causation. There could as well be other reasons for this to actually happen. Anyways, the good news is that this pattern is very faint and it gets even fainter with thinner extrusion. So smaller nozzles or lower layer height, because that elongates it to the point that you can barely notice it. Because it's so faint, it tends to smooth out with faster print speeds, because the length of the filament between the gears and the nozzle acts a little bit like a spring and evens out the extrusion. So if you had flat surfaces, which is where you'll see this most often, one way of getting a smoother finish is to actually increase the perimeter print speed to 50 mm a second or more. Now, that can sometimes cause other small issues, so it's a little bit of a trade-off there. But is the reason why in Prusa Slicer, models printed faster can sometimes look better than printing them with a quality profile. You'll have to go here and increase the outer perimeter speeds. Another good way of solving this is to use filament that is better at hiding small defects, like texture filaments with sparkles, and keep in mind that those can clog a small nozzle. Or you can use wax-like filaments, where light goes below the surface and scatters into the filament in all directions, making the print look smoother than it actually is. And of course, I've been using high-precision filament from Prusament and Fibrology. Less precise filament will start to show an uneven random variation, but because it's uneven, you don't normally notice it as much, and it'll add noise to this pattern and make it less obvious. So this is something I'd like to get rid of, but it's not really a significant problem, and we can minimize it drastically with the material choice and higher print speeds. Now hit that like button if you haven't done that already, and leave me a comment with your own observations if you have a 3D printer. And remember that your printer loves you, despite the patterns. Till next time, be awesome!